Good evening, everyone. Joe for Jaspy's Hobbyland here. 2016-17 Panini Select Basketball, brand new release. This is a half case divisional break number one from jaspyshobbyland.com. The second half also filled up already. I believe we'll be posting pick your teams tomorrow, so keep an eye out for that. So thanks very much for the fill, everybody. These folks right here, Michael Van Wy, Jeremy, Ziggy, Dakota, Paul, Virgil. Good luck. And there is the divisions right there. Let's roll the dice. 5 and a 1, 6 times for each list. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. We got Ziggy in the pole position and Dakota in the number 6 spot. This is unfinished right here. 6. This is a 6 box, half case, random division. Number 1 of the brand new, just dropped today, 16-17 Panini Select NBA Basketball. All right, 5 and a 1, 6 times for the divisions. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Is that right? You're a goalie. Central down to the Northwest. So here's what we got here. We got Ziggy with the Central, the coach with the Pacific, Michael Van Wy with the Southwest, Virgil, Last Bob Mojo, Atlantic, Jeremy 33, Southeast, Dakota, Northwest. So there you go, folks. That was the randomizing portion of the video. When we come back, we'll see if there's any trades in the divisions. There's usually not. And then we'll have the break. Stick around. All right. Welcome back, folks. There were no trades. So this is random division break number one from jaspyshobbyland.com. Ricky Holbert is saying in the chat, he was like, hey, if I was in this, I would want the Northwest division. What else would everybody else want, he asks. He likes the Northwest. Westbrook, Lillard, Jokic. You got Minnesota in there too, right? T-Wolves are in there. Karl-Anthony Towns, Wiggins, Chris Dunn, Gordon Hayward. Those guys. Well, the thing is, the basketball sells really well on a secondary market. You know, I was explaining earlier how well some of this stuff goes. Because, I mean, for a lot of reasons. A, they don't make a lot of basketball product, right? B, there are fewer professional basketball players in general. And there's more of a global market in, compared to, like, baseball and football, and American football. All right, 1, 2, 3 for the left side, 4, 5, 6 for the right side. And it's a 3. So 1, 2, 3 will be doing the left side. So this side will be reserved for the next divisional break, which already sold out. So there you go. I was kind of worried that this wasn't selling, but no, I had to play to the whistle. I had to follow my own advice. All right. So that's for break division number two. Number two. There you go. Exactly, yeah, John. Oh, John's like saying, yeah, especially in Asia, resells very well. It does. Yeah, if you get big hits out of any basketball product, always make sure you set that you do global shipping. eBay can usually handle, if you sell on eBay, eBay can handle international shipping for you if you've never done it. So it's a pretty good idea to do that. But yeah, sells very well on an international market. I mean, basketball is popular globally, you know. I honestly don't know if basketball is as popular in Korea. I'm Korean. I don't know if it's as popular in Korea. I know it's huge in China. Baseball is pretty big in Korea. But anyhow, yeah. Huge basketball-loving population in Asia. Europe as well, you know. Especially with all the Spaniards that we see in basketball as well. So there's a European market. So you'll be surprised at how normal numbered autographs, how well they'll sell on a secondary market. I saw, speaking of Nikola Jokic, Ricky, I saw a 2016-17, so not even his rookie year, a 16-17 Revolution Basketball on card auto of Nikola Jokic, right? Not numbered. Just a regular autograph out of Revolution, which is not necessarily the most, popular of the basketball products out there. Still sold for like $70. You know? It's not bad. Obviously, results may vary, but still, not too bad. All right. Two autographs or memorabilia cards and 12 prison cards on average. There you go. No one's saying that North Korea likes basketball. Hard to ship there. Right. Big Dennis Rodman guys up there. All right. So the design, I think, is pretty nice. Similar sort of nothing like earth shattering, but I like the kind of the wave look in the background that kind of makes it seem like there's like a wave pattern in the background. The refractors are not numbered. There's Kyle Lowry. Not numbered, but let's see. I think everything ships in here just because of all the different variations. No, veteran base doesn't ship. So vet base like this Damian Lillard will not be shipping unless that was a refractor. All right, there's Deli, Matthew Dellavedova, 164 out of 199 die cut. And Buddy Hield. Quick fact, Hield finished his career at Oklahoma and as a Big 12's all-time leading scorer with 2,291 points. That's still Pelicans' edition of Buddy Hield. If he was in his college uniform, he would have gone to Sacramento. But that goes to the Southeast, I think. I'm terrible with basketball divisions. No, that would be Southwest. Wayne Ellington refractor, that'll ship. Eric Bledsoe, Marc Gasol, and Malik Beasley. Nuggets relic for the Northwest. Quick fact, Beasley earned all ACC freshman team honors after leaving Florida State with 59 three-pointers made in 15-16. 59 three-pointers, that's a lot. There you go, Nuggets for the Northwest. That'll be Dakota. Southwest was Michael Van Wy, the Buddy Hield. This guy's been playing well. In spite of like how he's like 18 or 19. Kevin Love autograph? Yes. Nice one for the Central. 16 out of 49. Die cut autograph. Kevin Love, former UCLA guy. UCLA 95-73 over Kent State with still 2 minutes left in the second half. Go Bruins. Nice one for the Central. Ziggy with the Central. Nice. Bogdan Bogdanovic out of 299. Jabari Parker. And Bryce Johnson for the Clippers. Quick fact, led North Carolina in points, rebounds, field goal percent, and blocks in 15-16. There you go. And a tie-dye. Nice Willie Cauley-Stein for the Pacific. 3 out of 25 on that one. Pacific, that'll be the coach. Paul Nixon with the Pacific. The Pacific, huh? Could be some big hits in there. All right, next box. Good luck. Now, we are all backed up on breaks tonight, folks, so even if something else sells out, that'll have to be pushed to tomorrow. So big thanks, everybody, for keeping me busy tonight. I was a little nervous. I thought people would be out and about on St. Patrick's Day. It turns out, no, you guys are ready to break. You guys are ready to be out and about at Jaspy's, which is fine. Here is our break order for everybody in case you're wondering what's going to be happening next. And, you know, maybe you can kind of time it out, maybe schedule your own break after that and then pop back into the room when your break is about to start. Be sure to join our hockey channel, Jaspy's Hockey Land. Just search that on YouTube. And you'll be able to see our hockey only channel. You can break some stuff with Jason Jaspy as well. He's still on air, looking to fill some breaks, try something new. Stanley Johnson refractor, and we got nice on-card auto. Steven Zimmerman, 89 out of 299 autograph, going to the Southeast, I believe. Yeah, Orlando Magic, Southeast. Jeremy 33 with that autograph. And for the Lakers, Brandon Ingram relic for the coach in the Pacific. Nice. And green, Jaylen Brown. 1 out of 5. Nice. For the Celtics, goes to the Atlantic. My rivals. Virgil with Last Bot Mojo, all aboard the Big Hit Express. Whoop whoop! Green for the Celtics. Matches. I believe Jaylen Brown has been playing pretty decently, too. The entire Celtics team has been playing pretty well. They've rebuilt much faster than my Lakers, that is for sure. Jeremy Lamb for the Hornets. 138 out of 175. I believe that is also for the Atlantic, right? No, the Hornets? Yeah, the Hornets are in... We had a gold LaMarcus Aldridge, 50 out of 75 die cut. Wow, nice one for the Southwest in San Antonio. That's pretty strong. That goes to Michael Van Wy with the Southwest. And we got Copper Prism, Sparks, Dougie McBuckets, Dougie Fresh, 20 out of 49. Nice relic for the Central and Ziggy. Nice. There you go. Paul T's like, hey, I'm not a fan of the basketball, but Select looks nice. Yeah. Select generally, like Select and Prism are cousins, right? Prism tends to be a little bit cheaper, I think, if I remember correctly, and a little bit cheaper, and there's a lot more like base cards and stuff. The checklist is a lot bigger in Prism, but Select is a little bit more. The checklist is a little bit more trimmed down. You see a little more kind of vet autos and retired player autos in there. A lot of parallels that are numbered, which is also nice. The tie-dye refractors are in here too. So we had a lot of fun with that Select football. And I'm assuming we're going to have similar amount of success with the Select basketball as well. It's always a popular one. Whenever we do basketball. I've been getting a little bit better and better at basketball, DraftKings in basketball. Which is tough. I haven't really played a lot of fantasy basketball in general. I watch a lot of basketball. Don't play a lot of fantasy basketball, but kind of getting... Oh, nice. See that Ben Simmons refractor? Like, I won't be surprised if that sells for, like, $20 or something like that. That goes to the Sixers and the Atlantic. Nice. That would go to Virgil right there. Omri Caspi. 284 out of 299 for the Sacramento Kings. There he is again. That'll go to the Pacific and the coach. Got Kyrie, Relic for the Cavs and Select. Or and send in the Central. This is Select. Ziggy with that one. Dellavedova Refractor. And a gold Wesley Matthews for Dallas. 19 out of 75 for the Southwest. Michael Van Wy. So you got the LaMarcus Aldridge. And now you have the Wesley Matthews. And orange, Jonas Valanciunas. What is that? 42 out of 60 for the Toronto Raptors, which will be the Atlantic for Virgil. Nice. Gorgui Dieng for the Northwest and the T-Wolves. 275 out of 299. I don't think we've seen an autograph yet, right? Kawhi Leonard. There's the auto. It's a die-cut auto. Nice. Pulsar die-cut auto. Bryce Johnson, 45 out of 99. Nice. So Clippers, Pacific with that auto. That would be the coach with the Pacific. Wait, did I pass in Ben Simmons orange? Yes, all of them are good. Yes, they're all good. They're all good. I actually know. I don't have any idea like how this set will sell, but they're all good. Because since Ben Simmons is, oh yeah, absolutely. These are being sleeved up, so they'll be top loaded and sent out to the Sixers. I don't know how this particular set sells, but it's, yeah, that Pulsar probably sells for, there you go, yeah, that Pulsar sells for $70, is what PackFresh is saying. That just base refractor alone probably sells for like $20. Like 15, $20. So, nice one, Virgil. Last spot, Mojo, Atlantic. That's the great thing. There's so many parallels as well. So many Ben Simmons parallels in there. Sorry, Jeremy, among all the Ben Simmons kerfuffle, I was unable to talk to you about D'Angelo Russell. Jeremy33 asking thoughts on D'Angelo Russell. He's young. He shows flashes of brilliance. I think in general, it is hard to be a young and successful point guard in the NBA. I think it takes time. Got to run the floor. You got to have the maturity. You got to have all that sort of stuff. And with players being younger and younger and younger with the one and done rule, it's hard for point guards to be successful. How long? I mean, not everyone's Damian Lillard, right? You know? But think about all the other point guards that were drafted to be point guards and not just shooting guards, you know? That's kind of the issue. He's got great court vision. He can pass very well. He can shoot. You know, he can drive to the basket. He can play defense. He's got raw skills. But the other thing also is that he plays on a bad team. Who's he going to pass to? Who's he going to assist? You know, that's the issue. Like, you know, he can't be the other one defending. You know what I mean? That's the issue with the Lakers. So every mistake that, you know, D'Angelo Russell makes, it gets magnified, especially in LA, it gets magnified. And, you know, most players, it wouldn't be a big deal if he hung out with Caitlin or one of the Jenner kids, you know what I mean? But he does that, he gets into that issue with Nick Young, which is, you know, which is fine now, but, you know, then people start questioning his work ethic and this and that, and he gets a lot of flack. So there's a lot of pressure. Chris Dunn, on-card autograph for the Northwest, 112 out of 299. Points, which usually takes care of a, actually, since the auto is there, this must replace a relic, I would assume. That gets randomized to one person in the break. Now the question is D'Angelo Russell the guy to build a team around? I don't know, you know? Hassan Whiteside, 73 out of 199. Die cut for the Heat. That goes to the Southeast. And that'll be for Jeremy, 33. Throwback, tie-dye, yes. Isaiah Thomas. There you go. 1 out of 25, Phoenix Suns edition of Isaiah Thomas for the Pacific, which goes to the coach, Paul Nixon. Nice one, Paul. Right, everyone's saying no. You know, maybe you don't build a team around D'Angelo Russell. I mean, so, like, I could trade him if, like, I'd be fine if the front office traded him if they got the right pieces or high draft picks or something. He's not untradeable. You know, Julius Randle might be untradeable. Close to it. Brandon Ingram showing flashes of brilliance, too. There's Dirk Nowitzki out of 299. That goes to the Southwest. There, Zubac is doing well, too. But, I don't know. I think a lot of Laker fans, yeah, we're spoiled. We're spoiled Laker fans. You know what I mean? We expect the results like this. And trust me, watching the Celtics be as successful as they are, that bothers a lot of people in LA too. Reggie Jackson, nice. Two autos in here. There you go. 43 out of 60. Nice one for the Pistons. That'll be for the Central, right? Yes, Central. Going out to Ziggy. That was a waste of money right there. I like him though. So, listen, we'll see. You know, as much as I don't like the idea of tanking, you know, I think the Lakers have to. Yeah, did he use a Sharpie on this, guys? You can see kind of like the. Anyway, but the Lakers need another draft pick. They need to win the lottery, right? They need to finish in the top three. Otherwise, they forfeit their pick to the Sixers if they finish out of the top three because of all the stupid deals that they did and gave away draft picks, everyone, and blah, 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 blah. So if they don't get that top three pick, thankfully they got a low first round pick from the Houston Rockets for that Lou Williams trade. That was a smart move. And then I think the Lakers' strategy would be to just hope for it's either to maybe trade guys to get a higher pick, but I don't know if any of the top three teams that get that pick would want to trade to the Lakers for any of the guys currently on the Lakers. You know what I mean? Because a lot of kids, you know, a lot of like casual fans in LA who are like, well, just trade one of our guys to get the top three picks if we don't get it. And it's like, okay, well, who wants to give up the number one, two, or three pick for D'Angelo Russell? Maybe Brandon Ingram, but why would the Lakers give up Brandon Ingram, you know? So you're not going to get number one, two, or three picks, you know, because the Nets are going to get the number one pick. And guess who has the Nets pick? The Celtics. Oh, you know, so Celtics aren't going to help out the Lakers, you know, and the other two teams that get the two and three spot won't help the Lakers. So the Lakers just have to hope to do a little bit better in the free agent market if they don't get the top three pick. If they do get the top three pick, great. You know, I think that sets up the Lakers on a much better path to rebuild a little more quickly. All right. Next, there's Kyrie. Mike Conley and Jamal Murray for the Nuggets. Yeah, Celtics are going to be loaded. You think the NBA is failing, Jeremy 33? That goes to the Northwest, by the way. That will be for Dakota. I think the NBA is pretty strong. I really like David Silver as the commissioner. That I agree with. The one and done rule kills me though. That hurts the product. Ramon Sessions, remember him? Lakers had him for a little bit. 60 out of 99 for the Southeast. That die cut will go to Jeremy 33. Oh, and then Trevor Ariza, who's been playing nicely for the Rockets. That's 88 out of 99 if you look on the back there. Houston Rockets, that would be the Southwest. And that is for Michael Van Wy. Dario Saric, 127 out of 299. Robert Covington, 26 out of 175. That's for the Sixers in the Atlantic. I don't mind the cap expanding because guess what? Where's that money going to go instead? It's going to go to the owners. Domantas Sabonis, already rich owners. 18, 16 out of 199. Trust me. And that's for the OKC. That's also for the Northwest, actually, because of the old Seattle thing. Michael Van Wy. No, I'd rather have good guys like Lou Williams make bank instead of putting more pockets in the pockets of the owners. Because those TV contracts are huge. You know, the TV contracts on there are huge. And where does that money go? You know, you really think the owners are going to help, like, put in better concessions, lower the price of beer at the stadium, you know, with that extra money? No, of course not. No, they're going to put it in their pockets, man. I'd rather have, if anybody's going to get it, I'd rather have the players get it, you know. Try to get money, more money for players, you know, put a better product on the court. But here's my opinion on the one and done rule. Here's what I wish. And I think they do this in college baseball, if I'm not mistaken. Because I think if you're a kid, if you're an 18-year-old kid, you can declare for the draft and become and get drafted out of high school. But if you opt for college, I think you have to play for at least 3 or 4 years, right? In college, if you're a baseball player, why not do that for basketball? Because I don't like the idea of telling a kid who believes he can go pro that he has to go to, you're forced to go for a year. You know, baseball players don't go to college. Plenty don't. Look at all the high school kids that are drafted in the 2016 baseball draft. So I think that option would be great. You tell the 18-year-old kids, hey, you want to declare for the draft at 18? Go for it. You know, see what happens. If you think you're that good, go for it. Otherwise, you got to go to college for 3 years. Have to. Max, 3 years. One is a waste. It's a waste of scholarship money, too. I feel bad for the students, the non-athlete students. You know what I mean? Your tuitions are going to pay for scholarships for these kids that... Oh, how long is a school season? A school year? 9 months? 8 months? You know? Those kids aren't student athletes. They're just renting time at a university. You know? You think you like 2 years? 2 years could be good too. I can compromise. Alberto, if we're talking, if we're negotiating right now, I can compromise at 2 years. But I think three. I say three though. Oh, I see. Alex is saying you can commit for baseball. You can commit for a four-year school before the draft, get drafted, then decommit. Or if you don't get drafted where you like, you can head to school instead. Gotcha. Well, either way, I think I like the idea of, because I don't want to restrict any human being from going pro. I mean, tennis players go pro, golf players go pro at teenagers, as teenagers, et cetera, et cetera. If you're a basketball player, you want to go pro at 18, go for it. See what happens, you know? Because I think the market would correct itself. Wow! Kevin Durant, Warriors edition. 17 out of 60. That's for the Pacific, and that is for the coach, Paul Nixon. There you go, coach. Nice. More for the coach, David West, red. 148 out of 175. This is the last box. Oh, nice conversation, folks. I barely even noticed that we're at the last box already. Look at this. Finishing strong, die-cut autograph, Brian Grant for the Heat. 8 out of 99. That goes to the Southeast, Miami Heat. Southeast going to Jeremy 33. Ryan Anderson, blue, 287 out of 299. Yeah, Steve K saying, I think passing up a debt-free or reduced debt education is a foolish move. I agree with you, but that's why I'm saying, hey, 1 year is a waste for everybody. Monta Ellis, die cut for the Pacers, 35 out of 199. That is for the Central. That goes to Ziggy.
Joe, did you pick USC to upset or not?
Did not pick USC to upset. Sparks rally, Chris McCullough. 104 out of 199 for the Nets. And that is that, folks. I do have a randomizer. I got to randomize those points. All right, so good chat, folks. That was very, very nice. Nice chat about basketball. We don't get to talk a lot of basketball because we don't break enough basketball, but I'm glad that we have some of this select. We'll have another half-case divisional already sold out that's going to break a little bit later tonight. So stay tuned for that. And here was that nice hit on card auto, Kevin Durant. That is nice. Pacific, the coach, who looks like he's asleep. So maybe the went-to-sleep mojo striking again for the coach. 17 out of 60 on that one, Paul. All right. Everybody in this divisional has a chance at the 250 points that popped out of there, which I believe replaced a relic somewhere in there. Let's go back to the team list. So from Virgil down to Michael Van Wy, let's copy. Let's paste into a blank list. Let's roll some new dice. And let's do it 7 times on a St. Patrick's Day. 1, 2, lucky 7. 4, 5, 6, and 7. The final time. Ziggy with that one. There you go, Ziggy. 250 coming your way. Maybe get something off the store, collect some points together, make that happen. That was random division break number 1 of the brand new 2016-17 Panini Select Basketball. There'll be more in the store tomorrow, so be sure to check that on the website. This is Joe for JaspysHobbyland.com. Have a great night.